God has said that He is triune, that within His oneness there is personality. There is an eternal person called the Father, and there is an eternal person called the Son, and there is an eternal person that is called the Holy Spirit. In the Old Testament, this is inferred. In the New Testament, it is developed. What I mean is, in the Old Testament, you see the Messiah of God is called the Lord. He is called the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. It intimates that the Messiah will be divine. In the Old Testament, you get attributes of the Holy Spirit that He does things that only God can do. It intimates it. But when you get to the New Testament, you see the full development of the deity of Jesus Christ, the full development of the deity and the personality and work of the Holy Spirit. So God progressively reveals Himself in the Bible and shines the most brilliantly in New Testament revelation and in the incarnation of His Son. As a matter of fact, Jesus said that we are to baptize men in the name, singular, of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, because they are one in substance. They are all eternal, all unchangeable, all-knowing, all-powerful. But the one God exists within Himself of a plurality of personhood. And that is why He has never been lonely. He never had to create. He was complacent within the beauty of His own nature. I hear sometimes fellows ascribing to God a human weakness. They will say that God created because He was lonely. I'm sure God needed me to create and to really enjoy life, you know. I don't think so. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are eternal within themselves, and they have always been there. And this is why Francis Schaeffer once said that if the Bible did not teach Old and New Testament the doctrine of the plurality of a deity, he said he would still be an agnostic. Because those qualities that we deem precious, communication, love, would have been hypothetically qualities that were brought about by man. But they have always been there within God. He is triune.